morning, everybody, and welcome to another Jubilant Saturday, May 21st, 2022, episode 7, 26, part 1. Today's morning, your Saturday morning video for today is your Days of Praise passage, and we're in verse 11 of chapter 4 of Philippians, the next teaching from Philippians. And we're going to be learning how to be content. So if you're excited about this, we'll smash the like button. How do you be content? How can you be content as a Christian? Let me know. But subscribe if you're new. Turn on notifications. Share the video and channel with your family and friends. Help me get more subscribers. At least 15 to 20 subscribers by May 31st, which is now 10 days away. And Wednesday will be episode 7:30. And there will be a live video that day. Because I'll be celebrating 2 years of videos on YouTube. And I also will be trying to celebrate a little bit of my 2 years on YouTube, which will be 2 days earlier than usual. Which 27th is the actual 2 years on YouTube. But since I've got 2 years of videos, I might as well do both of them to celebrate both 2 year marks together. So stay tuned for that. And it'll be one video with the Days of Praise and the Daily Bread, all one video. That's the way I usually do when I do my live videos. I'll put both of them together. So all I know is one, the Days of Praise will be a God video, a God series Devo, and then you got the regular one in the other one. So we're going to be back in the God series once again. We haven't been in the God series in a while, but let's learn to be content. Philippians 4:11. I have learned in whatsoever state I am, therewith to be content. So the English word content can bring up thoughts of indifference and mild temperament. Modern usage tends to give content a negative connotation, as though such an attitude has little ambition or drive. And not so of the Greek term that the Holy Spirit chose for this passage. It is composed of the pronoun for self and the noun for sufficiency. Both in scripture and in secular Greek literature, the word demands an ability to conquer whatever circumstances that may oppose one's purpose or goal, and to continue through in spite of difficulties. So the context of today's passage, or today's verse, is a prime example. Paul had experienced hunger and satisfaction. He knew what it meant to be obscure and to be a celebrity. There were times when he had more than enough resources to accomplish what he understood. God had called him to do. And other times when resources were very scarce. So in whatever state he found himself, Paul had learned to be self-sufficient or content. So our problem is that we often are looking only at the physical and circumstantial issues and have not learned that our Lord Jesus provides grace that is sufficient for thee. For his strength is made perfect in weakness. 2 Corinthians 12, verse 9. So the resources of the omnipotent Godhead are enough for us to be content with such things as ye have, for he has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. Hebrews 13:5. So the self-sufficiency of the twice-born rests on the eternal fact that God, Philippians 2:13, worketh in you both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Amen? So that's all I have for you today on being content. Coming up tomorrow, we're going to be skipping verse 12 and jumping to verse 13 for episode 727, part 1. And we're going to be learning about Christ's strength, the strength of Christ for your glorious Lord's Day Sunday, May 22nd, 2022. So stay tuned to that. I'll get to that sometime later this evening, later tonight on Saturday, when I do my Sunday and Monday videos, and I might throw Tuesday in there if I'm feeling up to it. So, but coming up this evening at 5:45 with No Turning Point video, the Daily Bread passage is in the evening. So, but unless there's an extra video for that day tonight. But we're going to be talking about part 2 of episode 726 for your Jubilant Saturday, May 21st, 2022. We're going to be learning about the fruit sells the tree. And basically talking about the fruit of the Spirit. From Elisha Morgan, derived from Galatians 5, 22-26, which 22 and 23 is the fruit of the Spirit verses. So stay tuned for that. I'll get that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that after 5:45 this evening. So, with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Pretty short and sweet today. It's been that way the last 3 videos from yesterday's. They were all almost, I think I've hopefully got under 10 minutes on all of them. But I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Jubilant Saturday morning and afternoon. Come back again this evening where we'll learn about the fruit sells the tree. Sounds like a good one. I love learning about the fruit of the Spirit. I've always learned the different lessons that I've learned about the fruit of the Spirit. So, but with that said, I'll see you later. Goodbye.